This is the band's 10th anniversary in September, unbelievably so. The reason why we haven't played in America so much is we've played a lot more in Europe, especially in Italy, Belgium, France, Spain. We've never toured a lot of the places we will be playing before, for example, Salt Lake City and a lot of places down south. All first time round, and it should be fun. Travelling in the deep south between Naples and Taranto, and decided to stop off for an afternoon at the ancient city of Pompeii. And the remains of the petrified bodies really left a very strong impression on me. And it was whilst we were just messing around in a small studio, Cities in Dust, the music was playing, and that's when I wrote the song. I mean, it was supposed to be a B-side, but we decided to make it a clean A-side. The fact that we took quite a lot of time off writing was mainly to incorporate John within the group as a whole, and I suppose also to consolidate the group being a four-piece as well, simplifying the approach of songs, but also, I suppose, putting a lot more thought into the songwriting and arranging.
Yeah.
first song ever written for Tinderbox was Cannons, and that was at the end of 84. And I was watching an interesting program. It was about T.S. Eliot, but it particularly concentrated on a period of time, I think it was 1921, when he arrived in London, and they were having one of these freak droughts in London. And previously it had been hailstoning and snowing in spring. And this heat wave caused all the people to evacuate the town for shores, for the lakes. In their frustration, in their complete desperation, they tried to fire cannons into the sky to, I suppose, either thinking that the sound would break the cloud or the actual cannonball would pierce the cloud. And it was May 85 that we actually went into Berlin Hansa Studios to record. Troubled weather's on its way, tempest threaten us today. There's no respite for long dark nights, just a fantasy of spring. From the hailstones of summer to a scorching winter land, a frozen dead sleep and this heat beats down on this hot load of land. Closer to the core from city limits, fireball and in a headless chicken run, race red and screaming fire engine. Then the cannons came. Beneath the brooding sky, beneath its baleful eye, the cannon shot. The cannon crash, disturbing night behind a near ghost town, save the life of the cannons resounding. Still there was no rain, no rain, no rain, no rain. Once more in a line of fire, others a prey to sky. The cannons aimed at the eye. Degrees was inspired a lot by a story that I'd read by Ray Bradbury, and that included my recollections of being in Boston and Chicago the last time we were here, and it was so hot.
Did you know that more murders are committed at 92 degrees Fahrenheit than any other temperature? I read an article once. Lower temperatures, people are easy going. Over 92, it's too hot to move, but just 92, people get irritable.
Coming from Britain, you're just not used to, and that left quite a strong impression as well. So it was very much using an idea of this number 92 degrees, wondering if it is a temperature when there are most crimes committed.
Two degrees.
The songs were all written quite a long time before going into the studio, and so a lot of them have evolved separately. We always strive for a variety. I think probably we just had the time to be able to do that more consciously. Say that it is based around the weather, not just the weather. I mean, situations, events, and people's reactions to different weather. And so Tinderbox was an apt title for it, I think.